Hello, I wanted to give a short tutorial on how I go about analyzing images. A friend of mine sent me a link to an image from the James Webb Space Telescope, and I was playing around with it and I thought, hey, this would be a good opportunity to give a little demo. Okay, so enjoy. And here is the web page that my friend sent me. James Webb reveals complex galactic structures. Look at that, that is incredible. This is apparently a galaxy. And just looking at the caption here, IC5332, that's a catalog number for galaxies. So I'm gonna copy that. And I'm gonna go to one of my go-to applications for looking at telescope data, which is this, sky.esa.int. It combines telescope data across a very wide range of telescopes. Very easy, very good interface to use. Right now we're looking at that. That's the Crab Nebula. When you launch it up, it'll choose things to show you, right? So that's the Crab Nebula. Look over here on the left. This is the layers you can put on top of each other. We're looking at an optical image. DSS-2 is the Digital Sky Survey, number 2 in color, but we can choose different telescopes. Look at that, all those choices, those are all optical telescopes. HST is Hubble, let's see if there's a Hubble image of this. Ooh, that might be good for later research. Nice, good raw data. Okay, nothing that's beautiful from Hubble on this one. So let's go back, where were we? We were on Digital Sky Survey. Let's add on a new row, say in the near infrared. Ooh, that's nice. How about the mid infrared? Oh, look at that. Okay, so we're gonna do a near infrared, and then I'm gonna add also a new row of far infrared. Okay, whee! And you can change the opacity, right? So I can blend the images. And this is what's, one of the great things about this tool. You can blend the images from different wavelengths and different telescopes. We're looking at one object here, the Crab Nebula. We're looking at it at different wavelengths, captured by different telescopes, and we're blending across the telescopes to give us a fuller view of the image, this mysterious thing that we are looking at. Okay, got a little sidetrack there. Let's go to the IC5332, right? That was what we started with here. So I'm gonna type in IC5332. Oops, I got an editing problem here. It's gonna say nothing there. Boop. And there is the galaxy that is the subject of this video. IC5332, it's coming up an optical telescope, this Digital Sky Survey. Cool, I'm just gonna zoom out a little bit. Just for the heck of it, let's just see what else we got here. Look, can we see this in near infrared? Ooh, a little bit, not much. There's different telescopes one can choose. Not all telescopes have all the data on here, so you're not guaranteed to find a picture of this in any, oh look at that, in any other wavelength. I'm just showing that you can choose different wavelengths as your back that you're looking at here. Okay, so there's the object in question. You'll notice up here there's a couple of icons for Hubble and for James Webb. Hubble and James Webb have both made the effort to put some of their specialty images, high quality images into this tool. It's not the best integration, but it certainly is worth using. So I'm gonna click on the James Webb version since that's where this all started. It knows that I'm looking at this part of the sky. It calls up the pictures that I want. So let's look at this one, Webb, I see. Yeah, that's it, that's the one, right? That's the one that we started with. There it is. Now the blending, it's awkward with these James Webb and Hubble specialty images. You don't get to do everything you want. So what I'm gonna do is take this image and put it into another tool to do my own blending with it. I'm going to zoom in a bit so that I can, I'm going to get rid of those boxes. There we go. And I'm going to zoom in, nice big image. And on the upper right hand here is a, take a screenshot, and you can download this image. I already did it. So I'm just going to say you can download the image, save it to your computer. And then I'm going to look at the Hubble version of this. So there's the Hubble, oh man, baby. There's the Hubble one. It's amazing, right? And then I can save the Hubble version of this, download that. Now I want to blend them. You can use Photoshop. I don't have Photoshop on this computer. So a go-to online image editing tool is this one. I don't know how to pronounce it. Photopea, don't know. I'm going to load up one image. Say I put Hubble first. IC 5332 Hubble Space Telescope. Open that. There it is. Beauteous. Oops. Just want to zoom in. There we go. And now I'm going to open up the James Webb, but I open in place so that they can be layers. So they can be on the same image, but just layers of the same image. So open the James Webb. All right. So now you can see over here, here's the layers. We have the Hubble, and then we have the James Webb beneath it. I'm just toggling the visibility here of the top layer. Let me rename that. That's IC5332, Hubble Space Telescope, so I can keep track here. When you blend, you can, there's a lot of ways to blend. And the simplest is with opacity or fill. For these images, they're basically the same option. So opacity, I'm gonna toggle the opacity of the top layer, which is the Hubble Space Telescope. That's kind of awkward how it's blending out the blacks there. Let me try switching the order, see if it matters. Opacity, that's better. So there was something weird going on there with having the one image on top versus the other. I don't know what it is, don't really care right now. I think it had something to do with how the zero pixel was being stored. Okay, back to the project here. The top image is the James Webb. I'm going to toggle the opacity, and you can see there's the Hubble, there's the James Webb, there's the Hubble, there's the James Webb. And the human visual system is very advanced, and it will start putting things together for you if you give it information and let it do its job. Wow, so what I'm seeing, which I didn't even notice till now, is on the Hubble, there are these dark areas. Wow, didn't even notice those. Look at all those dark areas. And what do you want to bet? That those are exactly where the James Webb is bright. So we got to choose some features and check it out. Like right around here through this orange thing here, right? So that you kind of see like an S-shaped, a wiggle wiggle dark lane. Let's see if that wiggle wiggle dark lane. Yeah, pretty much. That's okay, it's not 100%, but clearly, like up here, let's look up here. There's nothing in the James Webb there. It's a dark area with the James Webb. What does Hubble give us? Yep, that is a very clear image for the Hubble. It almost reminds me, you know, the Nautilus shells when you cut them and they have the chambers in them. Kind of reminds me of that. The kind of segregation, In the plasma world is, it's a very elaborate, complex thing. Plasma does it very well, but so that you can see there's these like very well-defined boundaries. Can I zoom in on one of these boundaries here? Oh no, back up. Okay, I wanna zoom in. Man. Well, anyway, those boundaries are a clear delineation of energy levels, a very sharp delineation of composition. So whatever is along this thin line here is a very different energy and composition than what's over here in this dark area. And that kind of segregation is everywhere in the plasma universe. It's everywhere in biology too, frankly. You know, the body is segregated into, the muscles are in bundles, the nerves have their own segregation, the nerves go on their own channels, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, well, that was really it. I am done with the little demo. I'm just going to keep playing with this and hope you enjoyed. Bye. Thank you.